Today we continue with the series about the vegetables and we look after this ugly little fella, very ugly, the celeriac. Stay tuned! Hello everybody, welcome back, I'm Pasquale and I'm your nutrition and lifestyle coach. As in the previous video, today we're gonna continue with our series about food, nutrition and vegetables, and this time we talk about the celeriac. This little fella looks like this scabies parasite. It's really ugly, but it's really nutrition, and like in the last video, we're gonna talk about its nutritional value and we'll give you also some ideas on how to cook it and eat it. So, follow me.
Botanically speaking, the celeriac is the apium graveolens var Rapaceum, and I hope I pronounce it correctly because I didn't study Latin at school, and belongs to the Umbellifarae family. Celeriac is a botanical variety of the traditional celery. This variety of celery is called root vegetable because we consume the root of the plant, which is edible and has a large, rounded as knotty shape. It tastes like more delicate than the traditional celery. Celeriac grows easily in temperate climate zones and frosts can irreversibly damage the plant. The ideal weight of the plant when you buy it should be between 600 and 700 grams. The root is very peculiar. The color of the root is brown on the outside layer and white on the inside layer. As the best known celery, also the celeriac has great properties. Composed of water for more than 80% of its weight, it is low in calories and rich in minerals such as calcium, iron, magnesium, potassium and iodine. It has remineralizing and diuretic properties. Its aroma is due to limonene, which together with another substance called selenin has disinfectant properties. It also contains coumarins that help the cardiocirculatory system, and it has also a good dose of vitamins. The surface is wrinkled and very rough. The leaves that come out of the ground are dark green and are concave on the inside. Usually only the root is consumed, but also the leaves are edible. Even the external part is theoretically edible, but it would be better to cook it. If, after the purchase, you want to remove the outside, you can consume it raw. And I always say, eating raw vegetables will only give you benefits in terms of nutritional density, as you will better preserve the vitamins which are denaturated by the heat. Instead, upper and lower part of the peel must be eliminated. Being a root, take care to wash it well if you consume it with all the peel, maybe using one of those kitchen brushes. I also remind you that, as for the celery, due to the presence of some protein compounds such as IPG1, IPG4 and IPG5, the celeriac is one of the foods that can potentially trigger allergic reactions. So if you are sensitive to these substances, avoid consuming it as well as celery. Now, let's analyze the nutritional qualities in detail and then see how we can eat it in a very tasty way. First of all, we start with the label values per 100 grams. As you can see from the labels, the celeriac is double calories of the traditional celery, but we are still talking about very small amount of calories. It's only 26 kilocalories compared to the 13 of the traditional celery. The carbohydrates are pretty the same, but the only difference is that the sugar present in the celeriac are about the double of the quantity present in the traditional celery. The celery is also almost 4 times the amount of fibers, and a good note of proteins. Now, let's go and analyze the differences between the celery and the celeriac on the micronutrients. So, let's start with the vitamin first. Vitamin A is about pretty the same. Vitamin C is quite different. As you can see, the celery is about 18% of the recommended intake, 14 milligrams, while the celery is 10%, about 8 milligrams. Then, the other difference we can notice here are the folates, the so-called vitamin B9, which in the celery is about 8%, 16 micrograms, while in the celeriac it goes up to 26%, almost 51 micrograms, that is great. We also note a difference in the thiamine, the vitamin B1, which in the celery is about 16% of the recommended intake, while in the celery is only 5%. I think these are the main difference on the vitamins. Let's go now and analyze the minerals. Potassium is high in both of them, but as you can see in the celery is 23% of the recommended intake, 460 mg, while in the celery is about 320 mg, 60%. The amount of chloride in the celery is higher than in celeriac, and phosphorus is pretty the same, even if celeriac has a bit more. And the same happened with magnesium, from 1 to 6%. Now we can see the last part. As I was saying before, the nutritional difference in terms of calorie comes most from the carbohydrate. Now we can see also the percentage of the fiber differences. For the celery, the traditional one, we have about 4% of the recommended intake, 1.1 gram, while in the celeriac is 16%, 4 times the same amount needed, 4 grams. You will also notice NSP down there, which is non-soluble fibers. And as you can see, even if there's no percentage on it, you can see there's almost 4 times for the non-soluble fiber. These non-soluble fiber are really important because they don't get digested. It's those kind of carbohydrates that don't get digested and go through the digestive system without being absorbed, and help to make mass for the stool. Now that I finished to bore you enough with its nutritional properties, why don't we look at how we can use it in the kitchen? As you saw in my previous videos about peppers, you can either use as an ingredient of the Italian benzimonio, or use it in your salads. In this last case, you can dress it in a very simple way. For example, you can cut it into thin slices and then season it with extra virgin olive oil, lemon juice, and some little balsamic vinegar. Being the ugly brother of the celery, it will have the same scent and flavor, but with a lesser intensity. Its goodness is inversely proportional to its beauty. Or, as you can see from the video here, you can also use it raw, like a hummus, chopping it in a food processor, along with some garlic, parsley, mustard, a touch of Tabasco, and some extra virgin olive oil. It will be not dense and homogeneous like the hummus, but it will taste very fresh and particularly interesting and full of scents and flavors. A further idea is to make a delicious mash. As you can see in the video, it's very simple and fast. Cut the celeriac into chunks and then you can add half of a glass of milk and a nice touch of butter. Then cook it at very low heat until it's tender. At that point, add some black pepper, nutmeg, and nothing else. The taste is delicious and in my house always flies off. Moreover, it's a very varied alternative to mashed potatoes if you want to give a high satiating value, but a lot of those are carbohydrates. If you want an advice, but don't tell anybody I gave it to you because I'm still a nutritionist, you know, you can also use it as an alternative to French fries. Yes, yes, that's right, just cut it in the shape of chips, in the desired thickness, and then fry it in the oil until it's cooked. I don't usually fry that much, but if I have to, I use a deep fryer. If you don't have it, I recommend you to always fry in abundant boiling oil to speed up the cooking, to avoid the food to absorb too much fat, and, more importantly, to avoid that oil reaches and exceeds its melt point, developing carcinogenic compounds.
I really hope you like this video and you find my ideas on how to cook it, the celeriac, useful. Of course, I remind you I have a Facebook and an Instagram page where you can follow me, and I really appreciate it. If you like this video, please subscribe the channel and click the bell to get new updates. And you also can follow me on my website www.healthmefood.com, where you can find the list of the services I provide. If you like the video, please thumbs up and share on the social networks so you can help me to spread my message. So it's everything for now. I'm left to say only, eat well, live well, and smile. I see you next time. Ciao.